peppers.
Hello. I heard somebody was sanding down the pigs. Are you ready?
Ja,
ja. 80 kilometer her. It's 80. We have to push.
We are back from Roderskis. We ended on 36.5 kilometer. 2 hours and 30 minutes. That I think is okay. I almost started with this wall. Half of it is covered with Duke. Second half is ready for Duke.
That means I have removed all the asbest plates where you can get cancer from. If you breathe in dust from those plate walls here, it can stick to your lung and you can get cancer later on. Or not. They say it's pretty dangerous. Done removing it now. I like that.
What I like even better is look at this roof. So nice to look at it and see it's done. The building inspector is here.
It's made for fat people.
It's not made for fat people. It's made for me, not for you. How are you doing, buddy?
Good.
You look beautiful as always. My mom helped out a lot today. She cooked me food, dinner tomorrow, dinner for today.
Then I didn't have to drive home and make it and spend time with it. So I continue working.
It's coming a trailer here. That's all my parts from Germany to all my crashed cars here. I'm gonna load it off now.
Shit. How do I get through here? I'm not getting through here. Shit, how can I get a part inside there? Now, I think I have enough work to do the next days. Side part. So you see that it's also here. Now Niklas is arriving. Snus, mumriken.
It's a new day. Those are also lifted down yesterday. Those are also in asbest. This shit material. I have to get rid of it.
And the way to get rid of it is that it's easy actually. You just have to put it on a funnel in plastic. 2 layers of plastic around it. Pack it, tape it. Then you can deliver it for free to the garbage place. That's actually a good thing because in old days it was not free. People put it around everywhere.
Let me go back. There we go. Pancakes.
I packed down all the asbest in plastic. Now I'm gonna go and deliver it, get rid of it.
I am now at Niklas's place. You have an oil filter for me?
Of course.
Thank you very much. Bosch og greier, det ligger det.
That's quality.
Thank you. What you gonna do now?
Plukke opp en ny bil kanskje da.
You gonna pick up a new car?
Ja.
Ford Focus RS?
Ja.
Ja.
Langt til Førde.
Førde? Uff. Det var en long trip.
Ja.
Saturday morning. I'm gonna mount this one now. The last endeboard at this side. You see, I have my friends here. One there. And one here. Helping me keep it in place.
I'm just gonna be here working a couple of hours and then we go to the ski arena and go roller skis intervals. I can hear somebody have arrived here. Oh la la! Niklas, you? Been driving all night now?
Yeah. Hello. I'm tired.
Tired?
Yeah.
Happy with new car?
Yeah, of course.
Looks awesome though. You're a playboy.
So we are done with the roller skis interval. Anders Bekk her I dag, Jørgen. Selve sugen her, ja. Det var 10 guys, tror jeg. Hallo.
Nå en runde til.
Den er sunnig på den her, Anders.
Ja.
Den ser god ut nå.
Ja, den gjorde faktisk ikke det.
Hadde ikke vært for korona, kunne ikke fått den.
Fikk lyst på en fet burger, ja.
He wanted to have hamburger. Med extra cheese.
My brother is home for the weekend. He's cleaning stuff to his machine. Jeg skjønner, you're going toothbrush. Hva blir det bra?
Er det ikke det?
Jo.
It's lunch time. Second one today actually. And qualification in Formula 1. My father should be there, but he's busy doing some other stuff. He had to travel away.
I'm not sure, but I think the fuel indicator is not managed to making up his mind how much fuel is left on this one.
Sunday morning. And again, I'm not going to be here too long, I'm just going to be here a couple of hours. Then I go to the CrossFit at Gressvik. Today is it no running, today is the CrossFit.
Krafter da. Control kjølevæskenivå. Ja, ja, det tar vi senere.
Oh la la, we have 360 camera degrees angle. That's cool.
CrossFit is done. That was a really nice setup there. Now I'm actually just gonna quick change and dry myself, then change, and then continue at work. A few hours and then is at home and watch Formula One from Mugello. I love the track Mugello. We was there, you know, in 2016. We won the first race and we won P2 the second one. Nice memories.
I'm watching the second race weekend for TCR Europe. They're racing at Zolder in Belgium this weekend. To watch this is not good for me. I want to race myself.
Hey guys, Michelle Halder, she won the race, eh? That's unbelievable. Big congrats. And her brother finished P4. And they're running a family team all by themselves. I'm really impressed. And she's the first girl to win a TCR Europe race. So, unbelievable. Huge congrats.
So, one of the projects I'm working with now
is this crafter. I have now removed the damaged part. It was here in the corner and I'm straightening up this plate. This one was pretty bended backward. This is now getting the shape back. It's still a lot left to make it perfect before we are done, but it's getting there. This is the front piece. I cut it out. As you can see, this we have to change. New one I'm having here at this super nice bench. This is the pieces I need. And this one. I also have some more pieces further down here.
So this is what I'm working now. I decided to make this one finish before I continue on the Seat, which is parked inside there. That's because it's less work on this one than on that one. So I do the easy first and the hard one later on. I'm just done with a quick lap here at Family Sports Club. Normally we go roller skis on Wednesdays, but today it was so windy, we didn't do it. And now I'm quickly back to work after a fast shower. Now I'm gonna wait for my buddy Nico. Nico is coming with me. We are actually going to the other side of the fjord. I'm not sure how to explain this quickly and easy. The thing is, I bought a Sprinter, crashed one. I'm gonna go and pick it up myself. It's on the other side of Norway because it was so expensive to transport it here with a company. So I'm gonna borrow the Sprinter and trailer from Olav because I don't have anything here myself now to pick it up with because the car is so big. So I'm gonna go to Olav tonight, but earlier today I called Nico, my buddy, and because I'm gonna deliver something I borrowed of him to the roof here. And then he said, oh shit, can I come with you? Because he wants to go and look at a boat just a few minutes away from the place I'm going to pick up the car. So I said, yeah, why not?
Sock on there, Nico.
Here's the socks.
Didn't have any more at home? Empty at home?
Yeah, fuck, from the wife.
Ran away from the wife.
I'm not surprised tomorrow if Nico said, no, I don't have a boat, look, and I just wanted to come with you on this trip to get away from home. That's probably the reason. Huh? Is that the reason, Nico?
Take the extra algo also. Huh? Yeah, that's the reason. Fuck the wife and children. Go with buddies.
I really hope Molly don't see this movie.
Holy shit, we missed the boat with like 2 minutes. Well, that's hurry sometimes.
Yeah, here we are. It's a little bit dark, man. Vito is parked. Going now, Olav has made everything ready and stuff. Here is the Sprinter and the trailer, and we're gonna deliver this on the way, Jernhest. It's gonna be a tour, vet du.
Organizing me some food, da. Hello, boys. Are you guys hungry?
I will find your bed, Nico.
I find my bed, yes.
Our bed.
Our bed. I think it's a little rough. This
bed. You think the bed is a little bit too hard?
I think it's too hard for the neck.
I think I'm gonna manage. Are you sure there's enough pillows here, eller? Skal jeg gjøre alle putene bra? Sleep well, Nico.
Thank you very much.
This sleeping next to you is actually taking me back to old days.
Yeah.
When we was racing Clio Cup. That was a nice time.
It's 4 o'clock in the morning. Get up early and bright.
Trøtt, Nico? Look tired.
Little bit.
Okay, let's go then. I've been on a trip with this car before because I picked it up south in Germany last year. Now I'm gonna borrow it back.
Ola is a businessman, you know. Huh? No diesel left. Thank you, love.
Yeah, buying the diesel. The plan now is first deliver that Jernes on the trailer to a customer from Olav. I'm actually not sure where I'm gonna deliver it, but it's on before a mountain somewhere.
We'll find out of it.
And I'm actually pretty happy I'm gonna deliver this Jernes for Olav, because then the rent of the Sprinter and the trailer is gonna be for free, since I'm doing something for him also, you know. We are on the highway. Show me your muscle, baby. This is a V6.
It's 6 o'clock, we're in Seljord. Stine, I'm really sorry, but I stole all the knäckebröd from Olav's wife. I also stole salami and berinost. This I had one before.
Also, I got where they go.
Big cup.
Big cup of coffee.
Finally, some light is up. We still have 4 hours to go. Been driving 3. So it's a long trip, actually. Hey, boys and girls, this is a Europe way in Norway. And it's not a joke.
We are now at Esso Haukli, Hauklifjellet. Now we're gonna take off this one. That's good, Nico. Do some nitto for yourself. I'm gonna stay and watch. So there goes the Jernhest. We have a second coffee. Then we continue further on.
And we are back on the highway. Ah, that's a joke. It was a tunnel down the street here. It was closed. We had to go a special route to get around. There is the road again. But look at the place here. A lot. It's beautiful, guys.
This was an awesome place. That's a tunnel, actually.
This is nothing I see every day. Oil rig. That's huge. We are now in Karmøy. Nico gonna look at a boat. It's lying over there, but look at this place. This is really beautiful. I like this side of Norway.
This place is amazing. So the plan here now is that I'm gonna be here and be super negative and say that shit, that's not so good as the other boat you was looking at. We never looked at a different boat. This is the plan, we're gonna push the price. Can you guys imagine living like on a place like this? Or that place was really nice.
Here at the test drive. The price is not 10,000 euro lower. So now we're gonna wait a few days and we're gonna push it 10 more. That's the plan. As you can see, Nico, I'm prepared.
You're prepared.
I have lapper, brunost og syltetøy. So I'm quickly gonna eat this one before we go and pick up my Sprinter. And like always, I'm really curious to look at the Sprinter and see how the damage is, if it's good or bad.
Okay, then we push start. It's around 1 hour to the place Sprinter is.
Okay then, we are with the car. It's a company who have this place who do the pickup crash the cars all the time. They told me on the phone they could help me, but they had to go away, all of the guys now. So we are here alone, no winch on the trailer. So we are up for a challenge now. We cannot fire it up and drive it on. We have to find a solution to drag it on the top of the trailer now.
But actually, the worst thing is that the car is not looking good at all.